Welcome to Rokani Sports. How are you guys? Where are you watching in from? This is Rokani Sports and we are into the transfer season. And today I'm excited really to go into and record this one for you in here onto Rokani Sports because Bruno Fernandes wants Neves at Manchester United. Subscribe to this channel so as not to miss out on stories that we do upload in here on a daily. Now, when you talk about Ruben Neves, it's not a novice, it's not a new name into this Premier League one, because if at all you've been watching Wolverhampton Wanderers, if at all you remember the first season of Ole Gunnar Solskjaer, his second game after beating Chelsea by 4-0, you remember the second game we played was against Wolverhampton Wanderers, Anton Martial scoring the first goal into the first 15 minutes of the game, and guess who equalized for Wolverhampton Wanderers? It was Ruben Neves, well brought in corner and he carves into that ball in the back of the net, and David De Gea wasn't able to go ahead and save it. So that is Ruben Neves. He has become a custom name in the Premier League and very many teams have been looking to him, and ever since the departure of Luis, that coach is called people say that he's going to a team which goes by the name of Everton Wanderers. Is it Nespento, that coach of Wolverhampton Wanderers? Rumors are saying that Wolverhampton Wanderers want to sell their two players, Adama Traore and Ruben Neves, such that they can raise fees to give to their new manager, who is soon going to be announced in there, to go ahead and buy players to fix up the squad in there, because we are told that Nuno Espirito Santo left Wolverhampton Wanderers, and there is Fabrizio Romano, there is a new manager from Portugal, and he had coached Benfica way back, he's called Fabrizio Romano, came out and said that they are really looking up to him to sign him to become the manager of a team which goes by the names of Wolverhampton Wanderers. So they really want to go ahead and clear up some two big signings, and they want Ruben Neves out at £41 million in there. And guess what? This has triggered the man who goes by the names of Bruno Fernandes, man who has turned things around at Manchester United ever since he came on at Manchester United. That is Bruno Fernandes in for you. He has come out and said, guys, let's go and get Ruben Neves, because we all know that Ruben Neves is better than Fred and McTominay, because he can really play that role alone. You get, he's a box-to-box player, but I think if at all the manager gives him instructions that please protect my back four, do that CDM role very well, you can dedicate play, he's good at controlling the ball, he's good at shooting, he's good at that long pass, he's good at interceptions, tackling in there, he can win aerial duels very well, and he is this player that we need, because you know the work of the CDM more permanently into this football era is all about him getting that ball from the goalkeeper, all the four defenders, all Harry Maguire, all Victor Lindelof, all the man who goes by names of Eric Bay, all Twanze Bay, give the ball to Ruben Neves. Ruben Neves has all the football intelligence and genius to really get that ball and pass it to the Bruno Fernandes, because you know that passing wide the field is okay, Freddie can do it and Scott McTominay can do it, but modern midfielders don't do that. What they do, they get that ball and they pass it through the midfield, in the middle of the midfield. Guys, when did you last see Scott McTominay or Freddie do that pass through the middle of the midfield? You get? So these are the people that we need. We need a player like Ruben Neves, and Bruno Fernandes recommending him is not something that just came out of the blue, because he has played with him at the Portuguese national team and they have been together, and I think Bruno can act as an agent to bring this guy in, because Declan Rice being priced at £80 million, I don't fancy a Manchester United team, the football director Morta Taff and the technical director who goes by names of Terry Fletcher, to go in for a man who goes by the names of Declan Rice. £80 million. Yet today we've seen England play and Kevin Phillips has played very well, better than Declan Rice in there in the pivot, and he really spent some time to really get that ball from the midfield, sat down several players and created an assist for Raheem Sterling, and yet we can get him at 35 or 40 million pounds. That is Kevin Phillips in there from Leeds. And Leeds, we can even go ahead and get a player who goes by the name of Daniel James and tell them, get Daniel James 30 million quid or 25 million quid, add on a 15, and they get us that lad who goes by the names of Kevin Phillips. So to me, I think before we go for a Declan Rice, because he's expensive, first and foremost, he's expensive, 80 million pounds. We cannot go in and get a Declan Rice at 80 million pounds. Yet there is a Neves in there who can come in and do 90% of the job that Rice is going to do. Apart from Rice being English, guys, very many people are recommending him, but for me, I really think they are better midfielders. Kevin Phillips can really come up and do that job better than a Declan Rice. And seeing him the way he plays, I think Kevin Phillips is a better player when it comes to the ball distribution and controlling the ball, interceptions in there. I like his height, I like his aggressiveness, the way he distributes the ball, he is really the good lad. And by the way, in the game that England has won against a team which goes by the name of Croatia, he has been the man of the match. That is Kevin Phillips in there for you. Kevin Phillips has been playing for Leeds in there, and Marcel Bielsa trusts him a lot, and trust me not, he is the lad that everyone is talking about today in the news, as he really comes on to play for England, and England have registered their win today against a team which goes by the names of Croatia. So he's the lad, he's the real deal. So to me, I think if not Ruben Neves and Ndidi, and by the way, there is a problem with Ndidi, because the moment we went to Leicester City and bought Harry Maguire at 80 million pounds, trust me not, Liverpool can go to Leicester City and get a Ndidi at 40, 50 million pounds. United cannot go in and get him at that price. United will be told, get us a 60 million quid to get an Ndidi, because there is the way United is overpriced on players. Because I don't know how we negotiate our deals, but trust me, no, look at Diego Jota going at 41 million pounds to Liverpool from Wolverhampton Wanderers. But if I told it was United who wanted a Jota in there, United would have charged a 60 million quid in there. But Liverpool managed to get him at 45 and sell close to 15 million pounds in there. And now, a Ruben Neves, 41 million pounds, wanted by a team which goes by the names of Wolverhampton Wanderers. It's a real deal. We can go for that deal other than getting a Declan Rice, to me, whom I'm not so much proved on the high level, because we look at Ruben Neves, he's playing for Portugal, and Portugal has lots of talent. And if at all you look at him and Bruno Fernandes into the Portugal team, they link up very well. So if at all we get a Ruben Neves and a Paul Pogba plays alongside him, we put Bruno Fernandes in front of him, a Sancho onto the right wing, and Anton Martial or Rashford onto the left wing, and and Edson Cavani, always on, you know, leading the line, I think we'll be having a wonderful team, because Ruben Neves is proven. He's a proven player, and you've seen him. He's a big game player, and you've seen him punishing very many teams. By the way, he's a person who can really get that ball. He has that 40-yarder shot in him, 40-30-yarder shot in him. He's good at free kicks. He's good at really laying that ball into the 18-yard area of the opponent, especially from the wing. You know, those Kevin De Bruyne passes, you can really get them from him. So I think Bruno is spot on. If at all, he recommends Ole Gunnar Solskjaer to really get a lad who goes by the name of Ruben Neves, other than getting a Declan Rice, English player, not proven on the world stage, and we can see him flop. And by the way, he's not a player who really fancies to play for Manchester United. He really wants to play for Chelsea, and you've seen him pose with Mason Mount of this world, and let's see whether Chelsea can go in for him. But Man City also want a Declan Rice. But for me, I think if at all we get a Ruben Neves comes in at the age of 28, plays like three seasons, when a man who goes by the names of James Garner really matures, where he's playing at Nottingham Forest, I want to see a Ghana playing Premier League football this season, in here in the Premier League this season, at Brighton maybe in there, and 2 seasons later we usher in a Ghana in there for Manchester United, because Ruben Neves would have weared out, as you see, like some Nemanja Matic, who should leave Manchester United now. So to me, I really want to see Bruno's recommendation put into consideration, because a Declan Rice, being 21 years old, good player, I don't really underestimate him, but at Manchester United right now, I don't want us to have a Declan Rice in there. We rather get a Ruben Neves, Premier League proven, we are going to the Champions League, and this lad is going to do as great as Bruno recommends him. Because Bruno recommending a player, he knows what United wants, because he has been at Manchester United ever since January 2020 in there, and close to 2 years at Manchester United. That is Bruno Fernandes in there for you, recommending such a player. I think he's really good, a player of good quality, and I think we all want to see him at Manchester United, other than spending 60 or 70 or 80 million pounds on Declan Rice. We have other positions really to really look at, like the central defense. You see, Real Madrid have put close to 60 million pounds on Varane. Now, if I told you spend 85 on Sancho, 60 on Varane, that is 140, almost the 150 million pounds that have been offered to a man who goes by the name of Ole Gunnar Solskjaer. I'll done. So what we have to do is, let's go for a man who goes by the names of Ruben Neves, because we can collect some money from ourselves. Nemanja Matic, Juan Mata, offload Phil Jones in there, offload Jesse Lingard. We can collect some 70 million pounds from the people we are supposed to sell at United in there, and we can get in more money and get in a player like Ruben Neves. Declan Rice, very expensive, good player, but for me, I really think he won't do the job he wants at United. Apart from him being English, I don't see any other thing that really costs him 8 million pounds in there. There is no way we can pay 8 million pounds for Declan Rice. Yet, we have very many signings to make in here at Manchester United. So, that's what I had for you today. Bruno wants Neves at Manchester United. And I think that recommendation is on, because he almost ticks all the boxes of a CDM in here at Manchester United. I really need a player like him, because he's injury, he's not an injury prone player. He has played an average of 34 games per season at a team which goes by the names of Wolverhampton Wanderers. And remember, Wolverhampton, he has that big engine, that work rate is on. So I think Bruno fancying and Neves at Manchester United is a deal that we should go in for in there, because I think it's worth it. It's worth it. I really recommend it. What do you think about Bruno Fernandes recommending a Bruno Neves at Manchester United? You have the right to go in the comment section and tell me what you think. It's RD on Moroccan Sports. Please subscribe to our channel so as not to miss out on stories that we do upload in here on a daily. This is RD in here. And if at all you feel like Bruno has recommended a right player for Manchester United, smash a like on the video, comment and share. I'm out for now. See you ladies in our next video.